When is the right time to get help? I get a lot of calls from a lot of different people, and specifically when it's the person in need or the person who's drinking too much or maybe is drinking too much but they're not sure, or using too much or using but they think they can stop whenever they want and therefore it's not a problem. Or yeah, they can stay away from the booze for a day or two or a couple of hours or maybe half a week or but when something happens, they flip back to their old behavior or somewhat of an out of control behavior. So, do they really need help? They're asking me, and they're not quite sure if they need help. Not yet. You know, they want to get really bad, or they want to know if they're an alcoholic or a drug abuser or drug addict before they get help. And that's kind of their test, their, you know, litmus test, their acid test on, oh, is this gone over the mark, or are we still, you know, within the range of, you know, self-control and other stuff? Hi, I'm Anthony, Recovery Coach, and I'm going to talk about when is the right time to get help. Most of individuals are calling, and that's about 90% of people who ever go in to see a therapist, a counselor, an addictions specialist or family counselor, you name it, 90% of the individuals who go to their first meeting do not return. Why is that? Important question. I believe it's because they really hadn't sorted out. Are they one of those people who gets help? And, you know, as if help were a bad thing or if help were something that you really wanted to avoid at all costs, because if you needed help, that meant you were that sort of person. You were, my gosh, you might be an alcoholic or a drug addict. And only people who get help are alcoholics and drug addicts. So you think. See, these are presumptions that will be going through an individual's mind as they're seeking for help. Now, if I'm describing you, it's not because I'm a mind reader, it's because I've spoken to over 10,000 people over my 2 decades of experience in working in the field. The check they're using is, can I stop when I want most of the time, or at least some of the time? That's the big check, right? If they can't, then they kind of know they need help. But if they go cross that barrier of, well, I can't always stop, but I can moderate my use, so that's fine. So I use every day, several times a day, every other day, only on the weekends, but heavily, but I can moderate my use somewhat. Therefore, I don't need help because I'm not one of those people who needs help for their drinking or their drug use. I hope you see where I'm going with this. And if it's not completely obvious where I'm going with this conversation, the conversation, by the way, that you are having in your head, okay, and you have frequently, you meaning the person who's called me over the last 2 decades and the thousands of others, you, the person who's having this conversation in their head, what are the questions you're asking yourself to determine, oh my God, should I get help now? Because if I do ask for help, then I'm really in trouble. And that's the only time to ask for help is when you're really in trouble. Or something like that. There's a more pernicious, more destructive thought that's actually going on in the background. And I'm going to get to that a little later in this video. So please hang on for that. Okay, it's an important little conversation. But right now, I want to just come back and go over specifically when should you get help and why are you asking these questions in the first place? In other words, the questions of, I don't think I'm so bad off that I actually need to consult with another, get a coach, for example. And therefore, I'm going to hold off on getting help because I can maintain or manage my own consumption. Okay, that's the consideration. Because I can manage or maintain my own consumption, so you say, most of the time, some of the time, infrequently, every now and then, you fill in the blank when you can do that. I don't need to get the help of another. Okay, so there's a couple of presumptions here. First presumption is, now, a coach is able to influence and affect you to the point where I can control your actions. Ha! Not going to happen. Now, can I assist you to do what you want to do? Yes, very much. Can I pull out of you and, let's say, encourage and also discover what is actually there motivating you to either not use or drink or to drink? And by discovering these things, becoming more aware of them for yourself, not for me, for yourself, you can actually find better ways to go about not only managing your situation, but having that very personal and private conversation with yourself of why am I doing this in the first place? And can I get along without it? And how would I get along without it? Those are huge questions. How would I feel without it? Can something else replace it? What if I fill in the blank, have a nervous panic attack? What if I, after you stop drinking, what if I lose it with my friends, lose it with my wife, lose it with my kids, and I do something, say something that I regret forever later, and it causes me even worse trouble, so it's safer to continue to drink or continue to use. That way, at least I know that if I'm using all the time, I have A, an excuse I was using or drunk, and B, a safety valve, so you think. A safety valve. Drinking seems like a bit of a safety valve in order to diffuse, so you think, your tension. Okay? Now, bad news is it gets worse, meaning the tension, anxiety, ability to maintain a steady focus on what you're talking about, what you're saying, how you're reacting, your responses to individuals, your responses to situations, all those abilities reduce with every day, with every week that you're drinking and/or drug using. They get lower. Why? Because your body and your brain and your gut and all these things get accustomed to the presence of that mind-numbing, emotion-numbing, emotion-stimulating, mind-stimulating, call it what you like, whatever it's doing for you. It can be many things, but it gets used to those effects on your body. And because you're used to those effects, you kind of need, you think, to operate. And the only way you can operate is with them. So the more you use and the more you continually use, the more you become dependent to them. Therefore, the longer your duration of use, even if it is under your control or not too bad, not like Joe, who's a drunk and his wife kicked him out, or he can't work anymore, or he's arrested, or whatever, all those reasons or those comparisons that you make to other people, because you're not that bad as the other guy or lady. You say, oh, well, then that's why I can continue to do what I'm doing because I'm not like that. And we all know that Joe had to go to rehab, detox, he's got liver disease, liver problems, dying of cancer, his wife left him, her husband left her, you name it, all those things, all those justifications that go on. The working partner is no longer a working partner because they couldn't put up or keep up with the deal and the bargain. You have all these factors coming in that you weigh whether is this time to go get help? Maybe I don't need help. Maybe I need help. And so on. Oh no, just hold on. Just stop. Is help bad? Is help for people who are helpless, is help something to be avoided at all costs? is help something you only get if you absolutely need it, because really the strong people, the people who are really resolved and, you know, who have character, they get through the situation by themselves without any of that dirty word, four-letter word, help. Perhaps that's how you're thinking about it. Perhaps that's how you're considering this dirty word called help. Let's address this directly, shall we? With you specifically, okay? And I want to make this gentle enough, but forceful enough for you to understand and accept something. Bezos, Jeff Bezos. Did he ever get any help, you think, for anything? Steve Jobs, ever get any help? Elon Musk, is he building all those rockets? You think he came up with all those designs, sorted out all those problems on his own, built all those cars? I said, oh, no, but that's different, you say. Really? How's that different? How's one of these gentlemen getting help toward their goal and toward their purpose and their destiny different than you going toward your purpose and destiny by asking for and getting help? How are these things different? Or are they? Perhaps they're exactly the same. They both have destinies. Now, your destiny, oh, is that what it is? Your destiny is to continue using to the end of your days, because you only feel like yourself when you're using or drinking, so you say. But if it ever got out of trouble, or got into trouble and you couldn't control it, then you'd get help. That's probably the computation you're thinking about. So your drinking or drugging is the reward for you living the right sort of lifestyle. And this reward now is worth far more to you than some other destiny. In other words, you found heaven, that perfect place. That's the definition of heaven, by the way. It's that place where of serenity. You're happy, everything's good, you know. I believe the Islamic belief, or in the Quran, or there's an Islamic belief. And this is just me talking, so this is not quoting, but the idea of heaven or paradise is a place with rivers, fertile land, warm temperatures, and levels of abundance in the area. It's a peaceful place. It is like a beautiful grove or valley where the land's fertile and people are friendly and life is good. That's heaven or paradise. All right. So when you're in your version of paradise, usually that's a mental or emotional state. It's a physical feeling. It's how you feel, or an attitude. And you believe drugs or alcohol or pharma got you to that place, so you don't wish to be pulled out of that place. Or is that quite the same as when you first tried it, or that time when you felt so good? You know what I'm talking about. But you keep doing it again in the hope that maybe one day it will be that good again, or at least not too bad. You know, maybe it's just because you're used to it now. And even heaven gets boring, right? Even paradise would get boring. But hey, it's paradise. It's that perfect state. It's that, you know, perfect harmony of things and life. For the science geeks out there, homeostasis. Okay? For your non-science geeks, it is that more of on the spiritual realm. It's that place of harmony, peace, beingness, oneness, call it what you like, right? And you believe that drugs and alcohol got you there. So how dare I? Oh my God. So going to someone to get help off of this area, you'd actually be being pulled out of paradise. Ooh. I don't know. Sounds pretty bad to me. Or is it? Is it possible that your track has actually veered off and the reward that you feel that you were getting from your drugs or alcohol in the past or maybe in the present are slowly or rapidly taking you away from your place of serenity or paradise or heaven? Again, call it what you wish. Everyone has a term for it. When you're in your zone. For me, as an athlete, oh my gosh, I will work incredibly hard. I'll do what it takes to get into that zone because when I'm in the zone, that's heaven for me. So what is it for you? And that zone, if you will, stay on this analogy of athleticism. And is drugs and alcohol getting you there? Because why are we talking about this? If that is what you are trying to do, and you feel drugs and alcohol and pharma are getting you there, then getting a recovery coach, in other words, working with a team person, like I'm pretty much a team participant. I'm like with you. I'm wanting to know what you want to achieve and help you through that. That is my objective. It is not my objective to tell you what to do, as I said earlier, as if that would do any good, as if you would listen, really, So who is recovery coaching for anyway? For me? I don't think so. Like, seriously, I had my recovery a long, long time ago, like a long, long time ago. And I have dedicated my last qu couple of decades toward helping others, as this famous quote in When Harry Met Sally, I want others to have what I'm having, that feeling of control over my life, ability to feel good and better without drugs or alcohol, to share that competency and to level up. You see, most teachers know this, and if you're in a profession where you've got into the profession specifically because you wanted to know and discover more about it, you wanted to solve your own problems, so to say, or so to speak, that's the reason, that is an additional reason to become a teacher of, coach of, a mentor of a particular subject. So I can level up to higher levels, right? But as far as recovery goes, I haven't had a drink or any drugs for 16 years, Long or 12. It's been a long time. I've forgotten. I don't count anymore because I stopped, using drugs, 30, 40 years ago, and I was only an occasional drinker. So individuals who want to be, part-time drinkers, hey, I did that for over 10, 15 years. I know I can navigate that road incredibly well. I might be your guy, I think I am, to journey that road comfortably without any sort of shame or blame or expectation on my part. I know how to play that game very well of very casual drinker and completely in control. So, is it the right time to get help? What should you wait for? What are the questions you're asking? You can comment in the comments below, or you can text me. And I believe if you go to my YouTube channel, you'll see it's 778-747-3748, specifically about recovery coaching. You can also leave a voicemail there. I don't take calls or almost never take calls on that particular line. Let me know, and we can talk about forming a team working. Partnership, business partnership regarding your recovery, because what is recovery truly? I think it's about you achieving your destiny. And your destiny may be more than a mere feeling or temporary state that you might get or had gotten in the past while drinking or drug using or pharma using. I think it's more than that, and I think you're short selling yourself by not allowing you to give yourself that gift of partnership with a coach to level up. I'm Anthony, Recovery Coach.